Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Good morning and welcome on this Advent Sunday, the first Sunday of the church's year. Please do sit down for a moment. If I haven't had a chance to welcome you personally, my name is Reverend Cathy, and I am very excited to see you all this morning. You can see anyone who's been in here any time in the last year that the church looks a bit different. The start of the year is when the church starts looking forward to the coming of Jesus, the Son of God, as a tiny baby, vulnerable human among us. In honor of this, we have our Christmas trees out, and we also have this wonderful Advent wreath here. There are four Sundays between Advent and Christmas, inclusive, and there are four candles around the edge of our Advent wreath, and we have one in the middle, a white one, the coming of the light of the world. That's for Christmas Day. And we're going to light one of the purple ones this morning. And wreaths are often seen on doors, aren't they, at this time? And I hope you have all received one of these lovely little hoops. There's my unmade one. And I'd like to say here's one I made earlier, but I didn't. Jill did. So, this is week one. Week one, you're going to take your little hoop, your wreath, and cover it with your green ribbon. Next week, we will add to it with more. So by the end of Advent, you will have a beautiful wreath to hang on your tree, a wreath that we have built up through Advent. And thank you to Jill for organizing that. And thank you to Olive for her work decorating our beautiful church Advent wreath. And we're now going to pray as we light the first candle to signify the start of Advent. We're in purple and we light a purple candle, purple for waiting. So let us pray. Thank you, Mark. God our Father, the angel came to Mary and told her that she was to be the mother of your son. Though she was afraid, she responded to your call with joy. Help us, whom you call to serve you, to share with her in your great work of bringing to this world your love and healing. We ask this through Jesus Christ, the light who comes into the world at Christmas time. Amen. Thank you, Mark. And as we start our period of looking forward to what's going to happen, so we're going to sing our first hymn, which is a great hymn of Advent and speaks of the longing of the coming of Christ. Please would you stand as we sing together hymn number 35, O Come, Emmanuel. Quite a lot of verses in this hymn, as I look at it. We're not going to sing all of them. We're going to sing 1, 3, 5, and 6. 1, 3, 5, and 6.
7.
1, 3, 5, and 7. The choir tell me 1, 3, 5, and 7. Okay, have a lovely... You can join in the chorus at any rate. 1, 3, 5, and 7. Let us sing, O come, Emmanuel.
Oh, come, O come, Emmanuel.
And now, please would you sit or kneel as Eucharia leads us in our prayers of penitence.
Let us turn to God, acknowledging that we sometimes get things wrong. Your love gives us life, but we fail to live as your people. Lord, have mercy. Have mercy. You call us to do good, but we seek our own good. Christ, have mercy. You hear us when we cry for help, but we ignore the cries of others. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness. And lead you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now, because it's Advent and a period of waiting, we don't sing the Gloria during Advent. Just wait till the midnight service on Christmas Eve, when we burst into glory again for Christmas. But for now, we're still waiting. So I'm going to pray the collect prayer for the first Sunday of Advent. Let us pray. Almighty God, give us all grace to cast away the works of darkness and to put on the armor of light. Now, in the time of our lives on this earth, when your Son, Jesus Christ, came to us to join with us, so that when he comes again in glorious majesty to judge the living and the dead, we may with him rise to the life immortal, through him who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Now make yourselves comfortable, please, because we're going to have our first Bible reading, which Isabel is going to read for us. Is Isabel there somewhere? And this reading is taken from a book of the Bible that was written at least 1,000 years before Jesus was born. But this man who's writing, he knows what's to come.
A reading from the prophet Isaiah, chapter 7, verses 10 to 16. The Lord spoke to Ahaz, saying, "Ask a sign of the Lord, your God. Let it be as Sheol or as high as heaven." But Ahaz said, "I will not ask, and I will not put the Lord to the test." Then Isaiah said, "Hear then, our house of David, is it too little for you to weary mortals, that you weary my God also? Therefore the Lord himself will give you a sign. Look, the young woman is with the child and bear a son, and shall name him Emmanuel. He shall eat curds and honey by the time he knows how to refuse the evil and choose the good. For before the child knows how to refuse evil and choose the good, the land before whose two kings you are in dread will be deserted." This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
And thank you, Isabel. Beautifully done. And now we're going to sing our second hymn. This hymn is called the Gradual Hymn because it's the hymn where the gospel gradually comes into the middle. That's the next Bible reading ready to be read. And it is hymn number 223, ready for Christmas. We're asking God to give us joy in our hearts. Please would you stand?
The Lord be with you. Hear the gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin engaged to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary. And he came to her and said, "Greetings, favored one, the Lord is with you." But she was perplexed by his words and pondered what sort of greeting this might be. The angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. And now you will conceive in your womb and bear a son. And you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. And the Lord God will give him to the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever. And of his kingdom there will be no end." Mary said to the angel, "How can this be, since I am a virgin?" The angel said to her, "The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. And now, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month of her who was said to be barren. For nothing will be impossible with God." Then Mary said, "Here am I, the servant of the Lord. Let it be with me according to your word." Then the angel departed from her. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ. Thank you, Eucharia. And may I speak, and may we all hear, in the name of the living God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please do sit down. Well, we heard again an old story, didn't we? We will hear it and we'll hear more about it as we go through these weeks of Advent. In that reading from the prophet Isaiah, which Isabel read for us so beautifully, you heard the Lord say to the King of Israel, "Look, the young woman is with child and she will bear a son and he will be called Emmanuel." We sang, "O come, Emmanuel." And he does come. And we hear how the angel comes to a young woman and says, "You're going to have a baby." And she's like, "But I can't have a baby because I haven't got a man. That's not possible." But nothing is impossible with God. And you know what? Back then, having a baby, if you weren't married, was a pretty risky thing to do. And if you know the story, you know that Mary and Joseph ended up going to Bethlehem because the ruling power made them, and she had to travel a long way when she was pregnant, and she ended up in a stable. We're starting to set ours up here. And if you look round the church, you can find the people on the way to the stable. So up there are Mary and Joseph on their way to the stable. Over here somewhere are some shepherds, and at the back of the church are the three wise men. And gradually during Advent, they will come to Bethlehem, where God is born in the middle of the place where the animals are kept, in the straw, to a young girl who risks being stoned to death for having him, God comes into all the messiness and difficulty of our world. And those of you who have read my emails or seen our posters will know that today we're thinking especially of children who are having a particularly difficult time in our world now. And specifically, we're collecting toys for an orphanage. It's bad enough, an orphanage, isn't it? No mum and dad to look after you. No one to walk around with you in the middle of the night when you're crying or ill. No one to take care of you. But this orphanage is in Ukraine. So you're in the middle of a war zone as well. Now, somebody very special comes at Christmas. We know him as Father Christmas, but we also know him as Santa Claus. And Santa means saint in English, and Klaus is Nicholas. So St. Nicholas, Santa Claus, Father Christmas. If you look up St. Nicholas, you'll find he was famous for giving gifts to small children. No surprises there. And so, in order to help us collect the toys for the children in the orphanage in Ukraine, we have a very special visitor coming today. You may wish, if you're in the doing something else, to have a look and see who's coming down the church. Because he is coming to help us collect the toys to take to Ukraine. And we might need somebody, some people up here to help him. So, what we're going to do now is, if you have been able to bring something, or if you haven't but would like to join in with some music making, then you're going to be invited to come forward. My friend here, Santa Claus, is going to help collect all the gifts. And the people who are going to come first are our gospel choir, because they're going to sing for us while Santa Claus picks up all the gifts. And they're going to sing a very appropriate carol for this particular time. It's called the Calypso Carol, and it's number 60, thank you, in your hymn book. So do turn to number 60. Now, what we'd like you to do, if you feel so moved, is to join in with the chorus, as they sing this carol. See him lying on a bed of straw, a draughty stable with an open door. Jesus comes into the mess of our world. So as they start to sing, would you like to come forward with your gifts for children in Ukraine?
Love again, just as for us was the same for them, the praises of glory when he came.
Fantastic. And now you're all invited to join in the next carol that the gospel choir are going to sing for us. And in your order of service, you should have a little piece of paper that tells you the words of the chorus of that carol. So please again join in with the chorus. Fantastic. Thank you, everybody. Thank you, Gospel Choir.
Can I just say thank you very much? You've been extremely generous. Which
you have to shout louder.
This is exceptional. We're hoping to get some pictures from the orphanage. Being an orphanage, we may not be able to, but if there are pictures, they'll go through Cathy and they'll be available, so you'll see where your gifts are going. Thank you very, very much.
Thank you, Father Christmas. Thank you. I hope you heard at the back, he said, we're hoping to get pictures when they arrive, but we don't know. But do pray for those people anyway. And there is an amazing pile of toys here, so I'm just going to bless them on their way. Lord, thank you for the generosity of all who have contributed to this collection. We pray, Lord, that you will keep those children safe, that they will receive these. They will bring joy, and that most of all, Lord, they will know the joy of knowing you, Jesus Christ, light of the world. Amen. Thank you very much, everybody. Shall we?
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, Santa. And now let us stand and together declare our faith in God. In the words at the top of page 3 in your order of service. We believe in God the Father, from whom every family in heaven and on earth is named. We believe in God the Son, who lives in our hearts through faith and fills us with his love. We believe in God the Holy Spirit, who strengthens us with power from on high. We believe in one God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And now, please would you sit as Iris is going to lead us in our prayers of intercession. And this is prayers for each other and for the world around us. And today, she's going to start at the back of the church. So, Iris, over to you.
Good morning, everybody. This morning, our Advent Sunday, we're going to say our prayers as we walk around the church. If any of the children like to follow me around and walk with me, that would be brilliant. I won't feel so lonely. So, I'm starting at the door, where we welcome all those who enter in times of grief, celebration, fellowship. May they know God's presence of peace and understanding and love, to never be judged but accepted. All are welcome. Lord, in your mercy. The bell tower. We give thanks, Lord, for our dedicated bell ringers, who week by week ring out so that all around us know that St. John's is here in this community to serve. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. I'm at the kitchen now. We give thanks for this facility where we can offer sustenance, fellowship, a safe place to sit, perhaps make new friends. We give thanks to our Lord for this much needed place of community. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The font. We give thanks and praise for all the people, young and old, who have been baptized in faith, and for those yet to come. We pray for all babies who will enter this world. Not all will be born in comfort or even wanted, some born in difficult and poor circumstances. We pray to you, Lord, that there will be love and peace in their lives. Lord, in your mercy. Just walking down to the memorial chapel. A place we remember those who have gone before us. We give thanks for the bravery of those taken in conflict. A place to pray to you, Lord, for the memories of loved ones sorely missed. Let us be comforted that they know the peace of your presence, dear Lord. Lord, Lord, in your mercy. We come to the pulpit. I know we don't use it very often now, but it's still a thing in our church that we love. We give thanks for Rev Cathy and Reverend Eucaria and the ministry team for their dedication in leading us in faith, preaching the words of love and peace that our Lord Jesus sets so many examples of. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. The organ and the choir. We thank you, dear Lord, for the gift of music, the magnificent sounds from our organ and choir, who use their musical talents week by week to lead us in our services. Lord, in your mercy, our prayer. The Lady Chapel, a peaceful place in this busy church where we can sit in quiet prayer, always here to remind us of Mary, the mother of Jesus, who set an example of a mother's love, faith in troubled times, and determination to protect in the face of adversity. Lord, in your mercy. And the altar, the spiritual center of our church, where we pray for all those who approach the holy table, that they feel the unity of our Christian faith, where the words of the gospel are declared to guide us in our devotion to you, our God. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now I'm back to the lectern. The place where we hear lessons from the Bible, prayers are said for the world, its troubles and its beauty, news of events both here and in the community, prayers for the sick and departed. And we pray for this morning for all those that are on our prayer list at the back of the church. And we mention those that have been included this morning, the Swift family, Bex, Alex and family, and we pray for the recently departed, Marion O'Kendon, Carol Pryor and Sandra McCreary. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Lord, send us out in this season of Advent to spread the words of the gospel and remind us in this busy time that we are preparing for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Thank you, Iris. Sorry, I've got in my throat. Thank you, Iris, for your prayers. That was lovely. And now we're going to stand and share the peace together, during which time I shall grab myself a glass of water. But please would you stand as we come up to the peace. And when we've finished sharing God's love with each other, we're going to sing our offertory hymn. It's hymn number 304. Lord, the light of your love is shining, because we remember Jesus coming, shining as light in the world. This is called the offertory hymn because often we always offer the gifts, but we used to pass around a plate for collection. We don't do that anymore, but if you would like to give to the church, that would be lovely. Thank you very much. There are plates at the back. But first of all, we remember that the risen Christ, after his death, came and stood among his friends who thought he was dead. And he said, "Peace be with you. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you." So let us offer to one another a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Peace be with you.
Thank you.
The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, we give you thanks and praise through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your living Word, through whom you have created all things, who was sent by you in your great goodness to be our Saviour. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he took flesh as your Son, born of the Blessed Virgin Mary. He lived on earth and went about among us. He opened wide his arms for us on the cross. He put an end to death by dying for us and revealed the resurrection by rising to new life. And so he fulfilled your will and won for you a holy people. Therefore, with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, we proclaim your great and glorious name, forever praising you and singing.
Holy, holy, holy.
Lord, you are blessed and holy indeed, the source of all holiness. Grant by the power of your Holy Spirit, and according to your will, these gifts of bread and wine may be to us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup of wine and gave you thanks. He gave it to his disciples, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me."
Great is the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And so, Father, calling to mind his death on the cross, his perfect sacrifice made once for the sins of the whole world, rejoicing in his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension and looking for his coming in glory, we celebrate this memorial of our redemption. As we offer you this, our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving, we bring before you this bread and this cup, and we thank you for counting us worthy to stand in your presence and serve you. Send the Holy Spirit on your people and gather into one in your kingdom all who share this one bread and one cup, so that we, in the company of St. John the Evangelist, Mary, the Mother of God, Joseph, and all the saints, may praise and glorify you forever through Jesus Christ our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory be yours, Almighty Father, forever and ever. Amen. As Jesus himself taught us, so we sit or kneel to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. A word before we share communion. First of all, everyone is welcome here at the Lord's table. Jesus welcomes everyone to eat with him. You will have noticed, I hope, that the bread has remained in this container here called a ciborium and was prepared earlier by Maureen with sanitized hands. Similarly, the wine has remained here covered during the course of the service. So when you come to receive bread and wine, you will have the choice of either just receiving bread, which is what we did during lockdown, or, I will have a mask on by then, it can be dipped in the wine for you so that you can receive both the bread and the wine. But do remember that if Christ is present in all of it, he is present in each and every part. So if you just choose to receive the bread, you are receiving the whole of communion, which is what I'm about to do. If you would prefer not to receive communion, if that's not your practice or you're not comfortable with that, do please just come forward for a blessing, because God loves to bless everyone. Remember, it's him that's inviting you forward, not me. And if you need gluten-free bread, we have gluten-free bread available as well. The body of Christ. Let us pray. O Lord our God, make us watchful and keep us faithful as we await the coming of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, that when he shall appear, he may not find us asleep in sin, but active in his service and joyful in his praise, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. 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 So as we come towards the end of our service this morning, one or two notices, things to let you know are happening coming up. First of all, though, a thank you. Last week, Anthony and Mark came and spoke to us. We're raising funds for a new AV system so that we don't have a wobbly tripod with a rather elderly iPhone on it. And sometimes we're subject to the vagaries of Facebook. We're wanting to install a proper system so that we can live stream. Anyway, last week we had £2,000 in the pot. This week we have £3,500 in the pot. There is a thermometer up there, over there, which shows how we're getting on. And thank you to Cathy for her work in raising grants to help us. But obviously we're looking for all sorts of things as well. And our event yesterday, and the stalls will be open now after the service at the back with refreshments. So there's some wonderful Christmas presents available if you want to buy some. There's also raffle, which we will be drawing in an hour's time at 12 o'clock. So do get your last minute raffle tickets and join us for tea and coffee after the service. All those funds raised will also go towards our AV system. Coming up this week, we have lots of exciting things on Wednesday at our place of welcome. So that's when everyone's welcome into the church with tea and coffee and cakes and Wi-Fi and children's corner, etc. It's Elf Day. So if you're here on or can be here on Wednesday morning, it's for the Alzheimer's Society. It was their initiation. They will be coming around 11 a.m., they will be sending their elf, so do come dressed as elves. And all donations that are put in our plates that day will go to Alzheimer's. So we're going to have a bit of fun on Wednesday morning with elves. And thank you to Liz for arranging that. On Thursday this week, we have the first of our two pilgrim groups, Thursday morning and Saturday morning, one led by Sandra, one led by Maureen. So Maureen, do join us here in church for either of those if you want a little bit of Bible study. Or if you want to do, you don't want to come to church, but you'd like a bit of Bible study, Eucaria will be leading us on Zoom on Thursday evening, looking at a saint we often forget, St. Joseph. We think of Mary, don't we? And we think of God and we think of great saints, but St. Joseph, Eucaria, will be leading us in this week. Next Sunday, we've got two exciting things happen. Our MP is coming, Louis French, to give us a donation for the work in Ukraine. And also East Wycombe War Memorial Society, whose collection on Remembrance Sunday was for our work with Ukraine. Their chair will be coming and they'll be presenting us with those checks next Sunday. And after the service, Yvonne has organised for anyone who would like to, that's anybody, to join for lunch. And is it a Frawley, Yvonne? Get a Frawley. So I have been before, went last time. We last did it for harvest. It's a great bit of fellowship, and you don't have to cook. So I thoroughly recommend. It's not too expensive either. Do take one of our flyers at the back of church to tell you what other services are coming up in the following weeks. So the following week, we've got a carol service for Time to Remember, for people who perhaps are missing lost loved ones at Christmas. That's on the 8th of December. Then we've got the Civic Carol Service Sunday week with the Mayor. And if you like a good sing-song of all the traditional carols, 4 o'clock that Sunday afternoon. I won't carry on because there's a number of things, but do take a flyer. I'm not aware of any birthdays this week for anyone who's in church with us, but maybe I've missed some. Has anyone had a birthday this last week or got one the week coming up? Because because we'd love to sing you happy birthday, if so. But it doesn't look like it. So we're going to, as we look forward to the birthday of Jesus, in almost exactly a month's time on Christmas Day, we're going to sing our last hymn, which is a hymn that tells the story of what Mary said when she was told she was going to have a baby. Hymn number 39, Tell Out My Soul the Greatness of the Lord. So let us bow our heads and pray for God's blessing upon us and among us. The peace of God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, be with you and everyone you love, living and departed, now and forevermore. Amen. Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
In the name of Christ. Amen.
God bless everyone. Bye-bye.